Are you kidding me, man?
Guys, I'm here with a very special guest.
Nelly!
I'm here with Nicholas Manuel.
Nicholas Manuel from the streets of Cape Town, Godly Giemba. We're here with the rude boy and the farmer. My pineapple, man, I want a couple of pineapples.
I didn't find this out until recently after I started making these Tikka chicken videos. But you literally started this.
Is it? Do you think so?
Arshads Tikka chicken in the islands versus Ali's Tikka chicken in the repulse room. We are going to start with Arshad.
I've been to Arshad before. I had a quality experience with Arshad, to be very honest with you. I've never had Asian fusion cuisine. Is it Asian fusion cuisine?
Asian food bazaar.
Asian food bazaar. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Man is Hungarian. So pressure will make what they...
I'm a breast.
No, yeah. A lot of people say, nah, pressure is to try. Da, 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 da. But yeah. I like it because I'm into kind of a try. Well, I'm not going to say I'm into a droog type, but a breast has more meat for me.
Yes, that's how it looks. That's the naan.
Pep drops.
So this is Arshads. What's your relationship with Tikka? How often do you eat Tikka?
Look, I don't eat it as often as I would like to, simply because my wife, no? We grew up in Bak River Road in Crawford, right? So, there by the Pulse Road, there by Altaf,
yeah,
no?
Yeah.
My wife lived in Bak River Road in the midst of all the madness of Tikka every single night. The smoke, the smell. And she ate it quite often. Not me, I didn't really eat Tikka that often back when I lived there, but maybe once every 2 weeks or so, so regularly. But now, she can't stand Tikka chicken, unfortunately. So now, if I buy Tikka, then it's a big problem. The last Tikka I had was Muhammad's Tikka Lansdowne. And I like the Tikka, like, if you are wrong, top it into that sauce. Tikka. Altaf is also not bad. I've had Altaf many times before. And I asked him to make it strong, then it come out, the chicken come out this color. Blood red, my bro. So that's also not bad. But when it comes to consistency, I think my favorite Tikka, no? Is Ali's. Do you know Ali's? It's opposite Altaf. And it's maybe because I have a kind of a relationship with them since I lived there back in the day. But they always give me a really, really liquor diet. How's the tournament looking?
Who's... All of the places that you mentioned were in the tournament. And because we eat in like two different places back to back, you kind of like decide the, I mean, you know,
yeah.
Decide which one you prefer. Yeah, so.
How do you feel about what's happening with Arshad today? Still like a warm, no? Like a... Okay. So usually, okay, sorry, Arshad, go.
No, no, I just want to show they, so, yeah, but Arshads, you can see that they have also a salad. Sometimes they don't give the salad with the lettuce. I think sometimes they just do the onion and,
yes,
and lemon.
And the lemon.
Lemon.
Lemon drops and brutal pops. I must do that. The lemon brings out the flavor, so like, I mean, of all the time.
The narration in your videos always top tier.
Yeah, no, look. A lot of people will tell me, like, where do you come on these words? And we, how do you? And me, it's just like the top of my head. Check here, guys. Basted to perfection. Look at the beautiful char crispy end over there. And the meat. Nice and juicy as well. So don't talk to me about dry breasts. Come on, man.
So with the breast, no, you are getting more bang for your buck, right? Some places, they do charge more for their breast quarter than their leg quarter.
Yes.
But some of them don't. And so, if you're asking, like, what's going to be, like, more filling, it's going to be the breast. Now, yes, sometimes the breast is a drier piece of meat than the darker meat, which is the leg and the thigh.
Yes.
But if they are giving you, like, an extra bit of sauce, or they're marinated like freak liquor, then it doesn't make it up.
Yes, exactly.
It's succulent. There's
yeah,
no dryness.
100%. 100%. Nah, it's a deal, but like I will eat a quarter, no problem, but I'm always gonna prefer a breast all the time. Even at home, if Sunday's like we're making Sunday lunch, I'm eating the breast myself and my son. We enjoy the breast. My wife likes the dark meat. We must know the dark. Look at the dark meat there. Yeah, and on your side, how's life?
Good, man. Like, how old is your child?
He's turning 13 in September.
One son.
one son, that's it.
I also have a son, one child. A second one's on the way. It's been hectic.
Yeah?
It's been
how old is your first one?
A year and a half.
Okay, you're quick, back to back.
Back to back. I know that's how I want it. That's how
you
I want it.
One time.
Yes, and I want to retire, I want to travel.
There you go. Africa. Lovely.
If I have to go through this thing of watching a child every second of the time, otherwise they want to fall with a pin in their hand.
Yes, or something.
That happen. I don't want to do that every 5 years. I want to get that out of the way, God willing. But I do want a couple of children.
Mm. Also, so after number two, now that's on its way, we'll see how it goes.
We'll assess the situation.
Oh, okay. No, but you know, children are blessings, man. So, but I hear what you're saying. You still, and you are you 30 already?
30, yeah.
Okay. So you have time. Like you're saying, get it out the way, but do it now. And then when they're older, they can look after themselves, make their own food. Then you and your wife can do your thing. You know, enjoy your life together.
13, well, your son's 13, you're almost there.
I think I am there. I'm able to let him do his own thing. He can operate in the kitchen by himself. He can go to the shop, he can go yoga there. But still, the world we live in, a person can't so you'll always be a bit paranoid or a bit concerned when you're not with them and they're out there, but you know?
The busyness of family life is like, I took a break from the TikTok thing for a while. And I think you're also not that regular.
No, not on TikTok, not on socials as much. I haven't done a review in a long, this is the first time I'm doing like a TikTok, I haven't done a review in quite a while. And it's because we got the TV show now, Steak Back was now on Via. So that's every week, and we're currently filming 2 episodes per day, twice a week for season 3 of Steak Pick. So that keeps me busy. Then I work Monday to Friday, my normal job. Then it's family as well, you know, and many other things that I'm busy with in my personal life. So yeah, it's not. Yeah. I don't push out content as much as I usually like I did before the TV stuff. Not using that as an excuse, but. It does take a lot of time.
But I mean, the TV thing is a big accomplishment that came from you doing this social media things, you know? I'm sure.
100%, yes. And I still want to stay true to where I come from. So I still need to go out and do these things. Because I love it, and also because I feel like I must, man. The people like it, they enjoy it, and it shows them places where they can go eat. Eat in gyms. I don't like... Like, if I went to Arshads today and they gave me a piece of chicken, but it was, for example, they say it was off now for some reason. Eh? Not saying that Arshads chicken is off, I'm just making an example. I won't post that video. I won't say don't go eat there because the chicken is off. Yes, you should maybe let people know, but I would rather go to the establishment myself and say, yo, you gotta do something. You cannot do this. Because we're not in the business of knocking any businesses down.
Yeah.
We want people to have a fair chance and people to check them out. So.
And sometimes places make mistakes.
100%.
Maybe got them on a bad day at a bad
There moment. We go. Exactly. And you know, you can't really charge on that. So, yeah.
Yeah, we mustn't underestimate like what our videos can do because we might think, okay, no, it's just me. I'm just telling my small circle of friends not to go there because I had a bad. But you put that video out. It could be, you don't know how viral that video might go.
It spreads like wildfire and then it destroys their whole business completely. Yeah, man.
So,
but he's going to do a Gatsby tournament or something.
I think I'm done now. Tell me your show, I don't have DSTV.
Lot of people don't.
How can I watch it?
Only on DSTV.
Okay.
You know what? I was going to bring you a pack of sauce and I forgot it on the table when I came. Then I was thinking I'm going to turn around and I was like, nah, fuck. I just came through. But I will get it to you somehow. No?
I used to have a nursery, a plant nursery.
Yes.
So I wanted to grow like super hot chilies.
Mm.
You go onto Facebook, the only people who has these seeds are the white Africaners.
Yes. They love it. They fucking love it.
They're the only ones who's growing like the Carolina Reaper.
Reapers, and... yes, 100%. We did an episode of Steak Pick at the Chili Festival. That's the biggest chili festival in South Africa. I was at the ostrich farm here on the N7. So many people, bruh. A lot of people. We sold some t-shirts, we sold some sauces. We almost sold out of everything. These people come there and they love it and they buy it. And these Owens are drinking shots of hot sauce, super hot. I don't know how they do it, my bro.
Thoughts on Arshads before we try the next one?
I almost polished Arshads completely. I want to get into that bones and succulent there on the side of his wing. Arshad, consistent. I got a liquor spice, a liquor tang at the back of the throat. I don't know, my mouth is a bit raw or whatever. I didn't taste the naan, but the texture of it is how it's supposed to be. Brilliant. Sourced up beautifully. Chips is lekker, like tikka supposed to be. I also saw in one of your videos, you don't like it when the chips is on the chicken or under the chicken. What was it?
I don't like it. No, it's presentation, man.
Mm.
That one, I want to open it up.
Don't cover my chicken with the chips.
It must look lekker, yeah.
Quiet.
And that Arshads does that. The chips is on the chicken. You have to kind of like, you have to...
Yeah, flip like him.
But it's alright. It's not the, you know, the end of the world. But I feel like, and you would agree with this, you eat with the eyes first.
100%.
Obviously, there's some food that doesn't need to be look the prettiest, like a Gatsby.
Yes.
You know, sometimes the uglier it looks, the
better. Failed that.
Yeah.
Mm.
But with tikka chicken...
At Arshad, always top notch. I'm in Ireland. And as smart, I'll pop in at Arshads. For death sure. I'm sure a lot of you out there also enjoy Arshads.
What Arshads has over a lot of these places is the consistency. And they also have very good service. When you order that, everybody who goes to Arshads can talk about that guy that serves. He can do 10 things at once. Chips, freak lekker. Naan, 100%. I like that it comes with a salad. The only thing for me with Arshads, and I've said it before, is that I'm not... Liquor flavor, but not my preferred flavor for tikka.
Mm.
But that's now my own.
What are you looking for? Deeper, more pungent, more flavor profile, a lot more disco in your mouth. What is it?
I think maybe that's a nice way to describe it. For me, it tastes like masala and chili.
Right. Gotcha.
And I want more complexity to it. I want some lemon in there.
Yes.
I want to taste some garlic in there.
Yeah.
Yeah,
makes sense.
All of that stuff with the strongness. And I think that the next person that we're going to try has those flavors.
Oh, is it? Okay, let's go.
I don't want to lead the way.
Do I owe you money for this?
No, please, no.
What do you mean?
Oh, speaking of
money. Are you rich?
Price-wise, it was 144 Arshads.
Okay.
Two.
Uh-huh.
So what's that? 70
Rand. Yes.
And then Asian Food Bazaar, 60 Rand. So it's a 10 Rand.
Okay, 10 Rand. First time. That's the garlic naan.
This is just a regular naan.
Oh, it's a regular naan. It's not garlic. Baby. I think this is what you're looking for, my brother. You can show the crew there.
This is Asian food.
Aye! Check the charred edges and the fucking deep flavors
smell,
in your
smell.
Now that's where the garlic... I thought it was garlic naan. The garlic is coming off the chicken. And we got a pack of the salad, are you interesting? Have it on the straw. Look at this. Are you kidding me, man? Wow. Okay. And these are like fries. No, these are not like slap chip like you normally get in a tikka situation.
And this is where, for me, Asian food was all kind of lose points. I don't know how you're feeling.
No. I agree with you. This is like a crispy fried chip. Oh, it's not like a, like your standard tikka slap spicy, you know.
They didn't put look at them. They actually are innovating. They put some spice in the chip. So they are listening to some criticism, maybe. I noticed, I don't think these guys that work in the tikka shops that they are on TikTok.
Because
they don't recognize me. I did notice that this guy did give me a smile when he saw me. I don't know if that was any indication of anything.
First taste I get, a beautiful ginger.
Mm,
no, there's a ginger pulling out there. There's a broader flavor profile, no? Like this. You can taste a lot in here.
Wow. I'm not able to, like, the ginger is that is true. Mm. That's definitely ginger. But I'm not able to identify every single spice in.
There's definitely lemon juice also up in here. Like, it gives you your back of a lemon juice, a sourness, and like a darkness. I would usually, with my breast, no? I take a piece of meat, no? A piece of breast chicken or the dingers. And I put it in the naan. And then I take some chippies. And I put it in the macmia. Naan gebachi, man, you know what I mean?
Oh, I was thinking of that.
I usually, this is how I would, at home, this is how I eat my tikka chicken. Right, I mean.
Lekker.
Where do you study in Rylands?
Mm-mm.
Where?
Rossi Park.
Oh shit, okay.
When this tournament just started, I was having to go to Walmart Estate to get Tikka from this other place, come back to Lansdowne, get the Tikka from another place, bring it home. I'm wonder bagging the Tikka.
Yeah, just to keep it home. But you see, the thing is, people don't understand the behind the scenes, bro. They don't. And having food ordered and fetching food and bringing it home is totally different than coming in there. Well, you probably all know this. Sitting there, coming fresh out of the fryer, fresh out of the grill.
Yeah.
I'd prefer that at all times present, but you know, sometimes it doesn't happen that way.
So when you say I must do a Gatsby tournament, mm-hmm. other people have seen, what is going to be the next tournament? Acne, Gatsby, Salomis. I don't know if I'm ready, man.
Did you go to Mr. Khan? Then the pass was already for acne.
Mm-mm.
And biryani. My bro. Life-changing events. That is like, it's just different compared to the others, bro. For me. Yeah.
It's definitely worth doing, but it's not easy to do.
The time it takes for you to go and come back and then post also still.
Edit.
Anything's the worst. What about getting my purple sweet potatoes, man? Sensei.
If I knew you were going to eat it, I would have brought you.
Oh,
you have a garden space.
I have a cool garden space where I sell it. No, flat. But the thing is, did you study like...
No, I studied botanics. Accounting.
Oh, you look accounting.
I didn't even do bio at school. No.
What school did you go to?
Al-Azhar. I didn't. Oh. So I had to choose between physics and bio.
Hmm.
Or accounting and business studies. I was like, okay. I'm not going to be a doctor. I'm just going to study some.
Didn't your parents want to push you to be a doctor? Or
no,
lawyer,
but
or?
both my parents did bio and physics, and they both ended up in the business field.
Oh, okay.
So that's why I was like, that was my logic behind choosing those things. Then I got my degree. Lockdown just happened. Couldn't find work, and then I was bored at home, and then I found out I like gardening.
Why?
And then I started selling some plants on Facebook Marketplace.
What else do you garden?
I garden the...
The good stuff!
Also,
facts!
Yeah. I have inflammation on my left shoulder. So I garden the other thing.
Medicinal purposes, guys.
Medicinal. Purely medicinal. Made it into a cream. And it worked.
Asian food bazaar. I like it. Put a bit less ginger and make a slap chip. You know what I mean? A slap chip. Naan bread is beautiful as well. And I will polish it, yes, I'll suck the bones. But ginger keeps knocking at my door the whole time. Just find that balance, you know?
Too much ginger for you. Alright. Let's again, for me, I really like the flavor of this, the ginger. It's a plus for me, in my book.
Yes.
Chips is really taken away from the experience. Naan also, I would say, Arshad slightly better. Softer, but the naan is good. And I didn't have of the salad. But
I also didn't have the salad. I look like fucking what's it?
It's cucumber, lettuce, and carrot. Is the salad of do you factor that into your?
Yes, I don't want the salad in the bag. The only time I want salad in the bag is the carrot and onion acha when you get the bunny chow. Otherwise, don't give me fucking.
Just put in the back. I just want to know, which one do you prefer? I'll tell you what I prefer.
I know who you prefer already.
No, you'd be surprised.
Mm.
Okay, keep in mind, they now in the semi-finals.
Is that the semi?
This is the semi-finals. Whoever wins here
goes
to the finals. They're going to verse Muzamils.
Where's Muzamils?
Muzamils is the Tikka shop that's opposite the road of Golden Dish. Do you want me to say first? Do you want to go first?
Okay, come, I'll go first.
Alright.
Okay. Based off everything that we smelled here today, that we seen, that we tasted, that we put down our gullets, salad, lemon, chicken, chips, naan breads. Never ever had Asian food bazaar before. They came through beautifully. Stunning, amazing. Arshad, consistent. However, as Asad said, I would also like a bit more flair with regards to a party in your mouth, bursting flavors, dancing on the rooftops. But just because the ginger is going to be on my lip till tomorrow. Arshad, I'm going to go with Arshad because of consistency. We can always tell him, bro, just put a bit more flavor next time. Eh?
I'm gonna have to agree with you.
I think I knew that.
It's because of the overall package.
Yes.
Like, yes, they don't have the flavor that I prefer. Like, I do actually, if Arshads had this flavor, and yes, maybe a little less ginger is okay. But if Arshad had this level of complexity of flavor, they would have been, I mean, then they wouldn't even been a tournament.
Yeah, there wouldn't have been a competition at all. Congratulations, Arshad, just for the next one. Broaden the horizon, broaden the horizon. Ach, there's always room for improvement, you know, in life as a whole. But, yeah, guys must go out and go check out these Tikka places that we are showing you here, that Arshad is showing you. And you must check out the final that is coming soon.
Guys, and check out Nicholas's YouTube channels. Yeah, you actually have a lot of channels.
I don't have a lot of channels.
It's different names.
Yes, I've got the Steak Pig YouTube channel that's there. And I've got Go Binge, which is the production company. That's the YouTube channel that my content sits on as well. And that's it. And then TikTok is most now Godly Giemba Steak Pig. Instagram is Godly Giemba and Steak Pig as well. And then Facebook is Nicholas Manuel and Steak Pig as well.
And don't forget the TV show.
Yeah,
night.
Tuesdays, Fridays, Saturdays, via channel 147. On DSTV, if you do have it. If you don't, just steal the logins from somebody that
on
you know.
Today.
Yeah, no, something like that.